Hi and welcome. Have you ever had inventory sitting in your garage, a warehouse, or maybe with a delivery company, and you weren't quite sure how much was there? Perhaps you ship products to a partner, or keep a separate supply just for large B2B orders. Without tracking everything in one place, it's easy to oversell, miss restocking deadlines, or simply lose track. In this video, we'll build a clear, easy-to-use inventory tracker from scratch using a spreadsheet. We'll set it up to update automatically whenever you need, so you always know your current stock levels. We'll also add handy notifications so you never forget to restock. And if you don't want to build it yourself, check out the video description below. You'll find free, auto-updating Google Sheets templates for Shopify and WooCommerce that you can set up in minutes. Give them a try. Okay, let's set up a custom inventory tracker in a spreadsheet from scratch. First, we need to figure out how to get your store data into the spreadsheet. Most platforms let you export data, for example, as a CSV file, but that's really only helpful for one-time inventory checks. If you want to track your stock regularly, you need an automated solution. Coupler.io is a popular choice for e-commerce store owners because it's simple to set up, doesn't require coding, and connects with over 60 apps, including Shopify and WooCommerce. Let's see how it works. I'll walk you through setting up an inventory tracker for Shopify. The steps for WooCommerce are very similar. The first step is connecting your store. Next, choose inventory from the list of data types you can pull. You'll then see a preview of your data. It might look a bit overwhelming at first, right? Let's simplify it. I suggest pulling only the most relevant fields for your tracker, like product details, quantities, and storage location information. Some of the field names Shopify gives us are a bit complex, so let's simplify them now. I'll also move things around to make it easier to see what we're working with. To keep things simple, I'll convert the created at field into just dates. Next, I want to calculate the total value for each stock item. To get that, I'll multiply the number of units available by their cost. Let's place this new calculation right next to the cost field. In my tracker, I want to easily see products by location, and I think giving the locations clear names now will help later. So I'll create another formula like this one. It will return main warehouse for this specific address, secondary warehouse for the facility at Parliament Lane, and another warehouse for any other address we store products at. Here's how it looks. Okay, I think we can send this data to our spreadsheet now. From the list of destinations, I'll pick Google Sheets and connect it to an empty spreadsheet I created earlier. While the data imports from Shopify, I'll set up a refresh schedule. I'll choose to update the inventory data every hour, 7 days a week. And here's the imported data in our spreadsheet. Let's rename the other tab to Dashboard and create another helper tab called Params. Okay, first, let's add some filters so you can look up products by location or name. The warehouse names are in column O, so I'll pull the unique locations into the Params tab. I'll do the same for the product names from column B. Now, I can add two data validation rules. These will pull the lists from the Params tab and create drop-down menus for filtering, just like that. I'll leave some space here for key metrics and display the inventory data starting from row 7. First, I'll copy the headers, since I don't need the location details in this view. Grabbing the fields up to the column I will be enough. Next, I'll use the filter formula. It will look at the same range of columns and use several conditions. I want the warehouse and product names to match what's selected in the dropdowns. And to make sure it shows all products when no specific filter is chosen, I need to add these extra rules. And here's the full inventory list. You can already use the dropdowns above to filter, and the list updates automatically. Let's add some color to the table and set up a few more filters. I think adding filters for minimum and maximum stock levels will be useful, for example, when you want to find products that are about to run out. This will also help hide some strange negative values I seem to have. I should check Shopify later to see what happened there. I'll modify the formula. Available units are in column E, so I need to add similar conditions to the filter list. Yep, it works like a charm. I also have a field showing whether products require shipping. To filter by this, I'll add a checkbox and include this condition in my formula too, making sure I check the correct column in the data tab. The filter formula also works with text input. For example, I can set up a filter for the SKU column to find items whose SKU starts with certain characters. For that, I use the regex match formula, comparing the input text with the SKUs in column C of the data tab. I'll use the lower function on both the input and the SKU data to make the search case insensitive. So now, for example, I can find all products whose SKU starts with 1 followed by 4 zeros. It seems my Christmas trees match this. And now the promised metrics to spice things up. Let's count the unique product IDs and unique SKUs. These numbers will update as you use the filters. Let's also calculate the average number of units available for the selected products. And let's wrap it in an if error formula to handle cases when missing values would lead to division by zero. And finally, let's sum up the total value of the currently displayed stock. Now, let's make some final tweaks to the units displayed and the formatting. Adding some background colors for the filters and metrics won't hurt either. Conditional formatting will also make the data easier to read. I'll set a red background for products that have already run out, yellow for those about to run out, and green for everything with availability above 5. I can also add another formula to color every second row, making the table much easier to read. And I think we're good to go. This dashboard works well for inventory tracking, but there are definitely ways to improve it. For example, let's say you want to convert the value of your inventory into other currencies. Sure, you could use the Google Finance formula for that, but for professional use, dedicated APIs are often a better choice because they're more reliable, offer near real-time updates, and can provide more detailed information. While Coupler.io doesn't have built-in integrations for specific currency conversion tools, it does have JSON and CSV connectors that can pull data from almost any API. JSON is a much more common format, so let's see how that works. I found a website called Open Exchange Rates that offers an API for getting currency rates. In their documentation, I found the correct endpoint. I'll copy that and paste it into the JSON URL field inside Coupler.io. I also generated an API key, which I'll paste as a query parameter. There are other parameters you can use, but I'll leave those empty for now. Looking at the data preview, I can see it has pulled the current rates for dozens of currencies. Instead of hiding them one by one, I can go back to the source settings and use the symbols parameter to pick just the 3 currencies I need rates for. Now, I can hide the fields I don't need. The Unix timestamp shows the number of seconds since January 1st, 1970, which isn't very easy to read. So I'll create a new column and name it updated at. Now I can paste in this formula, which will convert the Unix timestamp into a much more readable format. And now I can hide the original timestamp field returned by the API. I'll send this data to the same spreadsheet, creating a new tab called Currencies. Let's also set this data to refresh every hour. Here are the latest exchange rates based on the US dollar. Now, back on my inventory tracking dashboard, I can create a new column to convert the value field into Swiss francs using the latest rates. I'll repeat these steps for euros and British pounds. And now, let's do some final formatting, adjusting the currency symbols and adding some more color. Using a different color for these new headers is a good way to show that this data comes from a different source. Just a reminder, the ready-to-use templates for Shopify and WooCommerce are linked in the description below. They don't include data from external APIs, but they do have all the relevant inventory data offered by each platform. Spreadsheets are really useful, but checking every single morning which products are running low can quickly become tedious. It's much better to set up an automation that sends you a list of these products automatically, maybe every morning. One way to do this is with Google Apps Script. You can write scripts that check your inventory at set times and send you notifications via email, Slack, WhatsApp, or other methods. But these solutions can be complex because they require writing and maintaining code. A much more simpler and equally powerful way to automate this is by using Coupler.io with apps like Zapier. Let me show you an example. In Coupler.io, I've set up another data flow. This one pulls data directly from the inventory tracker we just built. Let's say I only want to see products that have three or fewer units left. And to filter out those strange items with negative stock, I'll add another condition. I can also sort the results to display the lowest stock items first. And let's choose to only bring back the most important fields. Now, I can send this filtered data to yet another tab in our spreadsheet. And set up a schedule to refresh it every morning. Okay, let's head over to Zapier. Think of Zapier as a bridge connecting different apps. It enables you to set up simple rules like, when this happens in app A, automatically do that in app B. You can link multiple steps together to automate tasks, from basic to more complex ones. As a trigger, I'll set up webhooks by Zapier. Zapier generates an individual webhook link that I can copy and paste as an outgoing webhook for my latest data flow in Coupler.io. When Coupler.io finishes importing the fresh list of products running out, it automatically sends a signal using that webhook link. This signal then triggers Zapier to instantly send a notification to the Slack channel, just moments after the data is refreshed in your spreadsheet. You could see right here that the webhook signal was received successfully. Now, all you need to do in Zapier is choose which Slack channel should receive the notification. You can also decide what the message should say. Including a direct link back to the spreadsheet tab with the low stock items would be really helpful. Go ahead and test the entire setup. You should see a notification pop up in your chosen Slack channel almost immediately, complete with that handy link. If you're happy with how it works, just publish the zap and you're all set. And just like that, you've automated your low stock alerts, saving you time checking the spreadsheet every morning. And that's it. Now you know how to build an inventory tracking tool from scratch. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them below in the comments. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like, share it with others, and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss future tutorials. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.